This is Robert Ian with GouldSeek.com Radio. The first presidential election in which I was able to vote was 1984. A lot of people tend to overlook or forget that during the 1980s, Ronald Reagan cut federal taxes virtually in half, and as a result, tax revenues nearly doubled. It's taken a whole generation, but historic tax cut legislation has once again been passed. Cutting taxes is always a good idea. More economic activity leads to more production, growth, and opportunity. There are still plenty of issues that require resolution, like the debt, the deficit, the Fed, and the corresponding issues that surround those subjects. But make no mistake, lower tax rates, repatriation of foreign funds with the one-time corresponding windfall of tax revenues, coupled with a mindset of production and growth that can be actualized in short order, are fundamental building blocks for creating additional layers of much-needed change. There are many ways people and industries will benefit starting in 2018. The cut in the corporate tax rate from 35% down to 21%. The implementation of fully allowable deductions for capital expenses. And lower levies on repatriation of overseas profits. According to an estimate from Goldman Sachs, U.S. companies are currently sitting on $3.1 trillion of overseas earnings. For example, Apple has $252 billion overseas, representing 94% of its total cash. And according to data compiled by Bloomberg, Microsoft, Cisco Systems, Google Parent, Alphabet Inc., and Oracle round out the top five. A one-time repatriation tax of 14.5%, for example, with Apple, would equate to $36.6 billion in taxes. On the consumer side, chains and consumer brands expect the tax bill to boost demand for their goods and services. Many of those companies rely on middle and low-income shoppers for the bulk of their sales. And it is widely expected that changes to individual taxes, such as doubling the standard deduction, will increase discretionary income. Is the tax bill an economic panacea? No, it is not. But it is a critical first step to achieving other financial goals and tackling other previously untouchable political issues. There's plenty of work that needs to be done. Many changes that must be addressed. But as we move into 2018, there is good cause for guarded optimism. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, wishing you a happy new year. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. For two new big guests, be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.